My name is Lovely Alma Villabella, and I'm going to teach you about ionic compounds. What are ionic compounds? Ionic compounds is a chemical compound composed of ions held together by an electrostatic forces, which is called ionic bonding. When a neutral atom loses an electron and becomes a positively charged particle, then it is called cation. And while the other neutral atoms gains an electron and become negatively charged particle, then it is called anion.
Now, we will discuss about ionic bonding. But first, we have to discuss about octet rule. As this is needed for ionic bonding, this is vital to understand what is ionic bonding. Octet rule states that we need 8 total electrons in the outer shell or valence of an atom for it to be stable. To explain the octet rule, we will use Lewis dot structures of the elements sodium and chlorine. So, since sodium is on the first column of the periodic table, its valence of electrons or its electron on the outer shell are 1. While chlorine, since it's on the 7th column of the periodic table, it has 7 total electrons on its outer shell.
So now we are going to teach you and how are we going to name ionic compounds. So how we do we name ionic compounds? So for example, we have a given Na and Cl. You're just going to take the second element, which is chlorine, and change its three last letters, which is I and E, and just add or replace with I, D, E, which is now chloride. This Na is sodium, and we already changed the chlorine to fluoride. We have now the final name, which is Na to sodium. And Cl for chlorine, which we changed a while ago to fluoride. So now the name is sodium chloride. So now I'm going to give you more examples so you can understand more about our topic. So we have given KBr and MgO. So first, we're going to answer this KBr. So just like a while ago, just take the second element, which is Br, and the meaning is bromine. Remove these three last letters and just add IDE, so which is now bromide. Since we have the last element, we're just going to take the first element, which is K, and it's potassium. So now our final name is potassium bromide. So our next example is Mg and O, which O means oxygen. For some elements like oxygen, we're going to remove four or more last letters, and replace it with IDE. So oxygen, we're going to remove these four last letters and replace it with IDE, which is now oxide. And we're just going to get the first element, which is Mg, and means it's magnesium. So our final element name is magnesium oxide.